You see, the useful idiots, the leftists who are idealistically believing in the beauty of Soviet socialist or communist or whatever system, when they get disillusioned, they become the worst enemies. That's why my KGB instructors specifically made the point, never bother with leftists. Forget about these political prostitutes. Aim higher. This was my instruction. Try to get into large circulation, established conservative media. Reach, filthy rich movie makers, intellectuals, so-called academic circles. Cynical, egocentric people who can look into your eyes with angelic expression and tell you a lie. These are the most recruitable people, people who lack moral principles, who are either too greedy or too suffer from self-importance. They feel that they matter a lot. These are the people who KGB wanted very much to recruit.
But to eliminate the others, to execute the others, don't they serve some purpose? Wouldn't they be the ones they rely on?
They serve purpose only at the stage of destabilization of a nation. For example, your leftists in the United States, all these professors and all these beautiful civil rights defenders, they are instrumental in the process of the subversion only to destabilize the nation. When their job is completed, They are not needed anymore. They know too much. Some of them, when they get disillusioned, when they see that Marxist-Leninists come to power, obviously they get offended. They think that they will come to power. That will never happen, of course. They will be lined up against the wall and shot.
I take responsibility.
He's narrow-minded, egocentrical idiot who tries to earn his own popularity through participation in propaganda farces like this.
It is time to take responsibility. Call out hate, step up, and take action.
The highest art of warfare is not to fight at all, but to subvert anything of value in your enemy's country, be it moral traditions, religion, respect to your authority and leaders, cultural traditions, anything. Put white against black, old against young, wealthy against poor, and so on. Doesn't matter. As long as it disturbs society, as long as it cuts the moral fiber of a nation, it's good. And then you just take this country. When everything is subverted, when the country is disoriented and confused, when it is demoralized and then destabilized, then the crisis will come.